It was an early flight. I was up at 2 a.m. to be out of the house by 3, to get to the airport for 4:30, to be on my flight at 6:30. I was heading to North Carolina to race in the season finale of the US Pro Kart Series. It was a race I'd been looking forward to for quite a while. On the way there, I'd stop to pick up my friend Kevin, who'd be the mechanic for another driver. I am wearing a GoPro this weekend.
Huh?
Half an hour later, we were at the airport. Having just got to the airport at 4:30 a.m. as planned, a text then came through to say that our flight had been delayed by 8 hours. We did, thankfully, manage to swap to a flight which was only 4 hours later. It was still a long wait, but eventually, we did make it onto the plane. Finally, we made it to the track, ready to build up our carts for the weekend.
So yeah, here we go, this is it. Hey, good, how are you doing?
When we managed to find our team, Mike Doty Racing, the box we had packed and shipped our carts in was sitting there waiting for us.
I can't believe you put two carts in this small ass box.
It's like fucking Tetris, bro.
It was kind of hard, but we did it.
I thought it wasn't going to fucking work, and we were there for like 3 hours trying to figure it out.
We had to almost completely disassemble our carts down to the bare frame to get them to fit in the box, which meant we had a lot of work to do. Building a cart is a long and articulate process, and our delayed flight meant we worked late into the night, long after everyone else had left. Eventually, we got everything pieced together, and we were finally ready for the big weekend ahead.
But you don't want to feed it back like 100% because then the rear will just kind of step out and you'll...
After the team's morning track walk was complete, we made our final preparations and it was soon time for the first practice session of the weekend. My dad had arrived overnight and he would be my mechanic. Thursday and Friday would see 2 full days of practice with races taking place on Saturday and Sunday. The first session of the weekend went pretty well. I was looking stronger than I had done in previous races.
Hey, Wayne, let's just take that off and relax.
Even still, we got to work right away on trying to make everything perfect, making various changes to the kart setup and analyzing the data to improve my driving.
Because what you did is basically, you're braking straight, but you're bleeding off, and now the pressure's too light. So you bled off too soon.
Okay.
You need to hold maximum brake, maximum brake, maximum brake, maximum brake, and then you're bleeding off kind of just at that last minute.
In the fourth and final practice session of the day, things were still looking pretty good. It was still too early to get a proper gauge on where we really were compared to everyone else, but we still did seem to be in a good spot. Coming off a positive end to the day, we took the cart apart and cleaned everything up. It's customary at the end of every day to make the cart look as close to brand new as possible. We made another setup change for the next practice the following morning before wrapping up and heading back to the hotel for the night. I don't think they're into that.
Alright, good night, guys.
Good night.
Good night.
Yeah. Gary.
Yes. We are very close to you. See you, buddy.
See ya. Says.
You guys, you seriously have an obsession.
Yeah, I get the message. I get the hint.
You should get McDonald's ice cream.
That's a bad idea. We had one more day of practice ahead of us before getting down to business on Saturday. The first session of the day was strong yet again, as our setup adjustment from the night before had appeared to work in our favor. As the day went on, however, our position among the rest became increasingly unclear. Not all of our setup changes worked as we intended. The last session on Friday is the first proper chance to see where you stack up against the competition. For us, disaster struck as I suffered a mechanical failure only a few laps into the session, forcing me to pull off the track early. 24 hours earlier, things had been looking good. Now, we had no idea where we really stood.
If you're pushing somebody into this turn on the last lap, just be careful you don't drop your bumper. Because what happens is the person's going to get right here and he's almost going to come to a complete stop.
Race day arrived, and now things would start to get real. The 52-driver KA Senior Field would be split in half and divided into two pre-finals, with the top 45 overall making it through to the final, the main event of the day. Shortly before my race, I went to watch my friend Nolan Tidwell, who was racing in the KA100 Junior class. Their pre-final began, and then I started to get ready for my race. I'd ended up qualifying 15th out of 52, meaning I'd be starting 8th in the split pre-final. The first race of the weekend got underway, and I had a strong start, making it up to 6th at turn 1. It was only the first race of the weekend, but the racing was already cutthroat and aggressive, everyone vying for a higher starting position for the final. Eighth on the track, but penalties for the carts ahead meant I was moved up to 5th. This would have meant a 9th place starting spot for the final, but after another red flag, I'd line up 7th overall. The final began. Right away I capitalized on my best ever starting position at a national race to make up 2 positions at turn 1, meaning I was now in 5th, right there with the leaders. This was a new, but thrilling and brilliant place to be. All year, I'd been pushing to get to the front. And here I now was, finding myself in the fight for the win of this race. One driver got forced wide, and I went for the move. He held it on the outside, which cost me a bit of momentum, giving a driver behind the chance to go for a pass on a tight part of the track. This put a bit of distance between us and the leaders. I tried to work with them to catch back up, but it was to no avail, and we were out of the fight for the win. My camera died before the end of the race, but after more close racing in the final laps, I came home in 8th place. It had been a solid day. Even though another driver's rash move had put an end to my chances of winning, a top 10 was still a great result in such a huge and competitive field of drivers. After the race, I cleaned up my kart as usual, and then went to watch the final of the X30 Senior Class. We'd be doing it all over again on Sunday. so long after the sun had gone down. We studied the data, reviewed the onboard video, and just tried anything we could to find some speed. Whether or not we'd gone in the right direction would remain to be seen. For now, we had some time to relax. It was our final day in North Carolina, and the warmth of the previous days had been replaced by almost freezing temperatures. Qualifying was all right, but not quite what we were looking for, as I put it in 13th place. Starting from 7th in the split pre-final, a jump start from the outside row made it difficult to keep my position. By lap 2, I still found myself in a pretty good position, with the leaders not far ahead. Until some needless fighting from midfield positions meant we could wave goodbye to any chance of getting to the front. After being shuffled back, I tried to make up ground the best I could. Pre-final had not gone as I'd hoped. After getting a penalty for having my front bumper pushed in, I'd be starting 15th for the final. The few hours before the final gave us one more chance to try and find that extra edge. It was time for the final race of the weekend, and starting from 15th, I had nothing to lose and everything to play for.
Nice job, Adam. Great job.
Where did I end up?
10th.
Alright, so top 10.
Yep.
After fighting for the win on Saturday, Sunday's result wasn't quite the success I was looking for. But it had been a hard-fought race, having come from a difficult position and been pushed around to take another top 10 finish. My kart was left to be kept with my team at their base in New York. I was left with plenty to think about as I headed home. It had been a great weekend. This year is the only year I've been able to run a full schedule of national races, and each race has had its ups and downs. This weekend had been a clear step forward. I could have won the race on Saturday. All weekend, I proved my worth against some of the best in the country. It comes at an uncertain time, because racing-wise, I really don't know what next year is going to hold. Then again, if I asked myself a year ago what I thought my racing schedule would look like for this year, I would have expected it to be pretty empty. I guess you never know what's going to happen.
It is our pleasure to welcome you to Denver.
Ultimately, I've been able to do what I've done this year because of the countless hours of work I've put in to make it happen. Karting is not cheap, and it's been an enormous challenge to afford all of the massive costs that go along with it. I don't regret $1 I've spent on it though, because this is what I'm passionate about. Even if I'm not able to keep racing next year, the most important thing is that this year, I finally got the chance to compete the full national schedule I've been aiming to do in the 10 years since I started racing. The crazy thing is though, it feels like I'm just getting started.